am going to explain practically operators. So I am going to click here, and so here I am having one plus symbol. So operators dot html I am written, then enter, then click the control B, you will get like full screen. So here you have to take the like script tag. Why you have to take the script tag means inside a script tag only you can able to write the JavaScript program. So for example here, where a is equal to, I am having a 10 as a like one of the value, and where b is equal to, I am having the 2 as a one of the value. So here I am having the two variables, one is the a variable and one is the b variable. So if you observe here, is equal to is nothing but one of the assignment operator. Assignment operator means this 10 is directly assigned to a like a variable. This 2 is directly assigned to a b variable. That's why we can say that is equal to is nothing but one of the assignment operator. Assignment operator means you are going to give values to the particular variable. So if you do the document dot write ln of a value you are printing, after printing the a value, then you are taking the like plus and you are taking the like one double quotations. After the double quotation you are giving the like one more plus, and here you are giving the like you are giving the b. Why we need means a is nothing but one of the variable. In a we are having a 10 as a value, then after that you are giving a one why you need to write this one means to give a gap between the like a variable and b variable, you have to give this one. So now if you try to print this out, if you try to execute this program, observe here, a value is, I am going to give here, observe here, a value is 10, b value is 2, means I have displayed the a value as well as the b value I have displayed. So I am going to explain about the like addition operation. Addition operations means document dot write ln I am having. Inside I am having a, for example a I am having, a value is 10 plus b value I have written the like b. Now you can check the output here. Means a plus b is equal to like 12, we can able to get the value. But I don't want to display my value here, I want to display this value in a next line. So that's why I am giving here document dot write ln of, inside a double quotations I can able to give the br. Br means break the line. Okay, I got it. Okay, next one more thing, I did the like addition operation, but I am going to do the like subtraction. So document dot write ln of, then inside the this a minus b I have written, now you can able to get the like subtraction. Means inside a you are having a 10, and minus b means inside like a you are having a 10 and you are subtracting the 2, then you can get the like output as a 8. So in this place you will get the 12 as a output, but in this place here you will get the 8 as a output. But check in the browser. So 12 you are getting as well as the 8 also you are getting. I don't want to display the like addition value as well as the subtraction value in a like same line. So that's why again here I am giving the like one break. Observe here, this is a value, this is a b value, and this is the like addition operation value, and this is a subtraction value. In the same way what I am doing is, I am going to do the subdivision. Division means one forward slash. A by B. A by B means you can check the like output. Means you are dividing the something. Check here. How you can able to get this value means, but inside like normal 1 minute. For example, we will do like this, right? 2, 10. We will do like this, right? So if you are using the like division operator, if you are using this keyword 1 minute, if you are using this like forward slash, if you are using this forward slash means you will get the like output as like 5, means 10 by 5, means you will get the this one, this value you can able to get it, whatever you are having this 5 value, that you can able to get it. But if you are doing the one more thing I am trying to do. Observe here. Instead of this forward slash, I am using the percentage symbol. Then here you will get the 0 as a value. Means if you are using this percentage symbol, means whatever you are having the remainder value, that you can able to get it. Observe here. So if you are giving the forward slash means you will get the like this one, and if you are using the like division operator means this percentage symbol means you will get the remainder value. So these are called as whether it is like plus symbol or minus symbol or division or like multiplication symbol or whether it is an increment operator or decrement operator, these are called as arithmetic operators. And one more thing I am going to take here. And I am going to do the like multiplication. Multiplication means A into B I am doing. So here I can get the like output as a 20. Observe here. So A into B is a 20. I can able to get here. Like we are having the like one more thing here. And I want to give the like one BR, break the line here. I want to draw a one horizontal line. Okay. Now we got the like one horizontal line. After this horizontal line, I want to increment one value. For example, where I am having A1 is equal to 200 I am having. But if I do the document.println now, if I print the like A1, then you will get the A as it is A value. 200 you got here. Means this 200 is the value you have assigned to a like A1, and that A1 is placed inside a document.println. Now if you check the output, you can able to get this 200. Now observe here, we are going to next line BR. So after the like A1, I am inside a like a double quotations BR I am mentioning. Why I am mentioning means I want to, after printing this A1 value, I am going to break the one line. So that's why I am giving this one. Next, what I am trying to do is, observe here. Already A1 I am having. Then here in this case, I am doing the like plus plus. After the like A1, I am trying to do the like plus plus. So then observe here what you will get. So now here the A value is like 200, and in this place A value has the increment like 201, but value will not come 201. The reason is in this line value is 200 only. After printing this 200, then you can get the 201 in a like next line. Why you are getting the 200 and 200? Because you are doing the forced increment. Using the plus plus, you can able to increment the value. But after the like A1, if you are writing a plus plus, means that is a forced increment. Forced increment in the sense, first you have to print the like original value. Then after the printing value, you are like trying to add that value. Means, for example, here the document dot write lnf. For example, A1 I am having. Means here I have incremented the value. Even though I am incrementing the value, that value will not come because it is a forced increment. What is the meaning of forced increment? Means first you will get the like A1 value as it is. After printing that A1 value as it is, then later after printing that value, then it is incremented. Now if you do the like document.writeln of A++, then here you can able to get the incremented value. If you want, you can check here. So first 200 is 200 is print. In this line 200, in this line 200 is we got. Then in the next line, even though we are doing the like increment operator, but again here we will get the like 200 only. The reason is after the like A1 you have written the A++, it is a post increment, not a pre increment. If it is a post increment, means whatever the A1 is having the value, that value will print as it is. Then later we will get the like this plus plus value, incremented value we will get in a next line. But same condition observe here, but instead of doing here, we know the like output, right? 200 200, then 201. But instead of doing the like post increment, I am doing the pre increment. Pre increment means, what is the meaning of this one? Means before directly going to print the output, first we have to increment the value. Already we are having inside a A1, we are having the 200. First we have to increment the 200 into 200. We have to increment as a 201. Then we have to print here. Just observe here. Previously we were getting something 200 and 201. Previously we were getting the 200, 200, then 201. Now what we are doing? In case of the like forced increment, we are using the pre-increment. Pre-increment means first whatever the value is there, before going to print this value, for this we have to add the like one value. Then we will get the 201 as the like output. Then in the next line also you will get the same output only. In the same way, we are having the like one more thing, document dot write ln of, write ln I am having, for example, where c1 is equal to I am having a 300. Next what I am doing is c1 I am printing as it is. After printing the like c1, then I am going to give the like one br. I am giving the like one break. Okay, now if you observe, you will get the c1 value as a, observe here, 300 you are getting. So here I am going to do the pre-decrement. Pre-decrement means already we are having a c1. For that I am using the like minus minus. Minus minus means pre-decrement. Pre-decrement means either if you are keeping either decrement operator or increment operator before the variable name, that is called as pre-decrement. So in this place what you are doing is already you are having a c1 is 300 inside a like 300 you are going to do the like one operation, means you are doing one value means you are lessing something, so you can get here as a 2991. You will get, this is the like output you can able to get. If you want, you can observe here. This is nothing but a pre-decrement. Okay, so that's why if you are doing the pre-decrement, means the first value will decrement, then later you can able to get the output. So now I have covered the like arithmetic operators. Actually we are having the six types of the like operators. One is the arithmetic operators, logical operators, assignment operators, comparisonal operators, bitwise operators, and special operators. Now I have covered about the like arithmetic operators. In the next video I am trying to do the comparisonal operators. I am trying to explain about comparisonal operators.